Bonjour à toutes et à tous, bienvenue au podcast La Sueur, enfin podcast La Sueur. Aujourd'hui on inaugure un nouveau format, les rencontres La Sueur, puisqu'on va faire beaucoup plus d'interviews les prochaines semaines, les prochains mois. Donc le tout premier épisode avec la rencontre de Misty Copeland, ça nous fait extrêmement plaisir parce que ça faisait très longtemps qu'on voulait lui parler. Donc Misty Copeland, pour ceux qui l'ignorent, c'est une danseuse américaine qui fait partie du ballet, donc danse classique, et qui fait ses débuts au cinéma pour Nutcracker, Casse-Noisette, qui sort chez Disney le 28 novembre en France. Et donc on l'a interviewée, pas spécialement sur le film, mais vraiment sur sa carrière d'athlète, parce que c'est l'une des toutes premières afro-américaines à véritablement percer dans ce sport-là, dans cette discipline-là. Elle fut d'ailleurs sélectionnée parmi les Time 100, donc les 100 personnalités les plus influentes du monde, selon le très sérieux Time Magazine. Donc vraiment, c'est une pointure. Sponsorisée également par Under Armour. Bref, c'est quelqu'un, une personnalité atypique dans le monde du ballet. Elle nous a accordé quelques minutes de son temps pour répondre aux questions de Matthew, qui, si vous nous écoutez sur notre podcast, notamment le podcast NBA, m'accompagne généralement. Donc là, il a été jusqu'à Londres pour lui parler. Et oui, la soirée devient internationale. Bref. Voilà, on espère que vous allez apprécier ces rencontres, ce qu'on va multiplier dans les prochaines semaines. Merci du soutien, n'hésitez pas à vous abonner si la vidéo vous plaît. Vous pouvez aussi écouter cet entretien sur iTunes, Deezer, Spotify, puisque nous y sommes désormais, et puis également sur SoundCloud et toutes les plateformes habituelles pour les podcasts, dont naturellement Podcast Addict. Allez, à plus.
La question que je voulais vous poser était vraiment sur la différence que vous avez between dancing in a ballet on the scene with like people watching you and with the cameras.
It's very different. We rehearse in the studio and we have ways of working that we know are going to appeal to that setup by being on a stage and different type of lighting. And then again, you respond to the energy and response from the audience. And then you get onto a set and it's a very different experience. Like we're used to kind of this like one dimensional, like that's front. There's no other front. Yeah. This is the audience. And we know how to angle our heads and do things in a certain way that will be attractive in that way. But there's no, you know, it's limitless when you get onto a set. And so that was a lot to adjust to as well.
Obviously, being on a movie set, did it make you want to maybe act in the future in a different role? Or
I don't know. I don't know. You know, I feel like something that I've just learned throughout my journey is not to limit myself to what's possible. And I think that's so amazing about like the character of Clara within this film and just seeing her take on things that she thought she couldn't do and grow from them. And so I feel like, you know, I never thought I would have 3 books that I wrote. I never thought I'd be in a Disney film. So it's kind of like never say never and just go with what works for you in the moment. So right now I'm a ballerina, I'm a principal dancer at ABT, and that's my focus. So I wouldn't stop that to be an actress, but maybe one day at 45 I'll take on my first acting role in a film.
you were talking about the books you wrote and all that, and I've been doing my own work, watching your Instagram and all that, and I see you post a lot of videos of young kids dancing and all that, and how's it important to you to be that role model? The people look up to you.
You know, I feel like it's been something that's just really happened naturally and organically, that I've seen how much I've benefited and learned and grown and become stronger because I had mentors in my life. So I understand the importance of having that support. And so it's just kind of happened. It's like, you know, the more that young people see representation or they see themselves through someone that's succeeding, it makes them better. And so I love to post these images of these young dancers that, you know, see something that maybe they thought was never possible because they can see themselves through me. It's really beautiful.
And did you, growing up, have an inspiration yourself? Someone you said,
yeah. So many.
Could you quote one?
Or yes.
Like someone that you were like, I want to be like her, like him.
Right. I think initially was my mother, you know, watching her raise 6 children on her own and really, really struggle. That strength, I always was like, I want to have that. I need to have that. And then Mariah Carey, when I was a young girl, seeing her, I think as a biracial woman, I definitely connected with her and related to her, and seeing her succeed, it was like, wow, maybe I can do something with my life as well. And then Raven Wilkinson, who's an African-American ballerina that danced in the 1950s and experienced a lot of racism. And just seeing her made me feel like I have a bigger purpose. It's not just about being a ballerina in American Ballet Theater, but I could be the voice of so many Black dancers that didn't get an opportunity like I have, and be the voice of so many to come that anything is possible with hard work and support.
All right, that's perfect.
So nice to meet you.
It was really
nice.
Shout out to all the youngers, man. I got a dream. It's a vision out there. Go take it. Go chase that dream. Sweat.